This is the plastic Grenadier Platoon blister for the Iron Cross book in Flames of War. The infantry or Lanzer were the backbone of the German army. While Blitzkrieg used tanks and assault guns to punch holes through enemy lines, it was still the infantry regiments that followed on to clear pockets of resistance and secure objectives. This blister is for a Grenadier platoon. Panzer Grenadiers have their own blister with less riflemen, more MG34 figures, and different unit cards. Let's look inside. The blister contains four sprues of medium grey soft plastic figures. It says this is enough to build six MG34 K98 rifle teams, two command teams, and a 2.8cm anti-tank rifle team. There's one of this sprue, the plastic SMG team. It has 10 figures, mostly armed with MP40 submachine guns. One figure is an officer with a pistol, and there's an unarmed officer figure. These will go on the command team bases. Some people don't like the soft plastic infantry. However, these are not bad. The facial detail seems okay. Some details are a bit exaggerated and chunky, necessary to cast well in this material, but these look alright. I'm basing some of the original Desert Rats British plastic figures at the moment, and these new German sculpts are a significant improvement on those early soft plastic figures. Next up come the plastic rifle team sprues. There are two of these, each with 10 figures armed with K98 rifles. Each sprue has two grenade-throwing figures as well. Again, the sculpts here are fine and there's enough variation of pose to mix it up and stop all your bases looking the same. The last sprue is the MG34 and 2.8cm gun crew sprue. There's only one of these, unlike the Panzer Grenadier platoon blister where you get two. It has three figures carrying MG34s, one firing, one prone firing, and one with it slung in the carry position. There are two figures carrying MG34 ammunition, and one soldier steadying an MG34 on his shoulder. The remaining two figures are the 2.8cm gun crew along with the four-part gun. Also included in the blister are seven medium bases, six for the infantry rifle teams and one for the gun crew. There are two three-hole small bases for the command teams and one set of base plugs. The supplied cards include an Iron Cross formation card and a generic movement orders card. The unit cards cover the Grenadier Company HQ as well as a Grenadier Platoon card. There's also a sniper card. More on these later. Let's look at the Grenadier formation on Forces of War. The HQ is two MP40 SMG teams for 2 points. If we look at the Grenadier platoon, you get options for taking platoons with 5, 7 or 9 MG34 K98 rifle teams. Given the blister gives you 6 medium base rifle teams, that's enough to make a 7 team unit if you use one of the small bases to make a K98 rifle command team. However, this would only leave you one small base. Not enough to make the two HQ SMG teams as well. To field the 9 rifle team platoon, you'd need another blister. Let's look at the Grenadier platoon unit card. This is an infantry unit with the Stormtrooper's special rule. This means the unit can attempt a second movement order in a turn if they succeed in their first. Careful use of follow me or shoot and scoot here can give German troops a useful tactical advantage. These are seasoned, confident troops with a 4+ motivation and a 3+ last stand. They're also careful being hit on a 4+. Combined with the standard 3+ infantry save, this can make your Grenadiers tough opponents and hard to kill, particularly against standard Soviet infantry who can match the motivation, but have less skill and assault stats as well as being easier to hit and having a worse infantry save. Movement is pretty standard for Flames of War infantry. Given these are primarily rifle teams, the firepower is a bit limited. The MG34 and K98 rifle teams have a 16-inch or 40cm range, with a halted rate of fire of 2 and moving of 1. Anti-tank is 2 and firepower is 6. This rate of fire is less than the MG34 teams of Panzer Grenadiers because they have a lower proportion of automatic weapons per platoon. Platoon options include being able to add up to 2 MG34 HMG teams at plus 2 points each. These would add considerably to the platoon's firepower and look like a worthwhile addition. Heavy MG34 teams can fire up to 24 inches or 60 centimetres with a rate of fire 6, reducing to 2 if firing on the move. As is standard for small arms, anti-tank is 2 and firepower is 6. This is a heavy weapon team and has an assault rating of 4+. The heavy MG34s are available in a separate blister, GE759, at $9. This contains four MG34 HMG teams. You can also add one 2.8cm anti-tank rifle team for plus 2 points. On the plus side, this does give you an anti-tank capability, but it is a bit limited. Good against light tanks and other vehicles, but you wouldn't want to rely on this against heavier opponents. Designated a heavy anti-tank rifle, it's actually more of a light field gun. It used the squeeze bore principle, where a wide shell was squeezed thinner by the tapering bore to achieve a higher muzzle velocity and thus greater penetration. However, the gun had a number of issues, including a short effective range, weak beyond armor effect, and short barrel life. But the main factor that caused this gun to eventually be withdrawn was the AP shells required tungsten and manganese, both strategic metals that became increasingly scarce later in the war. Flames of War stats for the 2.8cm rifle give a range of 20 inches or 50 centimeters, a halted rate of fire of 2 and moving at 1. Anti-tank is 7 with a 5 plus firepower. While this does give the platoon some anti-armor capability, it's not going to hold the line against T-34s or KV-1s. You're going to want to supplement this with better anti-tank guns or tanks in support. This gun also has the no HE rule, limiting its effectiveness against infantry and gun teams. If we look at the forces for Iron Cross, grenadiers can also be taken as a formation support option by other forces like tank companies. These get all the platoon options and same stats as the grenadier formation platoons. These are less points and you can field larger platoons than panzer grenadier units. You would need to balance this against the higher rate of fire of the panzer grenadier platoons. Adding in the heavy MG34 options, which panzer grenadiers don't get, and you get similar firepower but more teams on the table. This could give you an infantry formation that's harder to break. So that's the Grenadier Platoon Blister for Iron Cross. Grenadiers were the backbone of the German army and these are a solid choice. The figures are okay with decent sculpts and variety. Detail is as good as can be expected in the soft plastic medium, which has improved. I would be happy to put these on the table. The number of teams you can build from the blister is a bit odd. If you build a 7 rifle team unit, you won't have enough small bases to also field 2 HQ SMG teams. You could use the other small base with a single rifleman to field a sniper, although the actual sniper figure is GSO215, a separate special order purchase at $3. Otherwise, finding another small base might get you just enough figures to field the HQ as well if you make use of the MG34 crews as well. Be prepared to fork out for a second blister if you want to field the HQ and the 9 rifle team grenadier platoon option. You might also find two MG34 HMG teams worth buying to field with this platoon. Grenadiers are confident, competent troops that you can count on. Certainly a solid option for German lists. Thanks to Blitz and Pieces for supplying this kit for review. Their support is helping Fog of War continue to review a wide range of new Flames of War kits. They're still generously offering Fog of War viewers a discount on version 4 Flames of War kits from their online store until the 31st of this month. Enter Fog of War 2019 Q1 at the checkout. I urge you to give them a try. You can also get free shipping on orders over $200 Singapore dollars.